This time, Rahul Mangan here is a Group Chief Executive Officer of Treasury Consulting Group and also a venture capitalist. Today, we are going to shoot a very small video on a topic which is that is digital securities offerings, which is DSO, requires a sandbox approach or it do requires that a startup approach. But before moving further, I would like to describe what exactly is a sandbox approach and what exactly is a startup approach. So let us take an example of Project Ubin. Project Ubin has been done, is basically currently under phase 4, if I recollect correctly, and this is a project by Monetary Authority of Singapore, one of the finest central bankers in the globe and one of the preeminent central bank of the globe. So under Project Ubin, what exactly is what Monetary Authority of Singapore planning to do? They would like to have the first digital currency of the globe, which is Sing Dollar, provided the project will try and test it completely. Of course, there are multiple phases of the project. There are multiple combination of the project. It is very difficult to substantiate that what would happen, how would happen, but I have a complete trust and faith on Monetary Authority of Singapore, and I'm damn sure that they would be able to make it happen. But what exactly is sandbox approach? This is what the sandbox approach is all about. When you have a central bank, so if you are thinking that such kind of sandbox approaches are not possible in the different parts of the country, different parts of the globe, this is absolutely incorrect. We will come to that. Sandbox approach means there is a central bank or a body which has been created by the central bank. In this case, it is Monetary Authority of Singapore. The body will select the multiple startups and they will either own that startup or they will fund the startups, or in either of the cases. Like in this case, the funding is done from Monetary Authority of Singapore. It might possible that sometimes the regulator come in the picture and they buy that startup. So there is nothing wrong in that. Actually, practically speaking, there is nothing wrong in that. It's just a mindset that, you know, exactly people are having a negative connotation mindset. Now, it's just like a controlled environment whereby central bank or that appointed regulatory authority will try and do justice with the concept. They will see how good is the concept and till what extent we can make the concept possible. Now, exactly how it would go, you know, Monetary Authority of Singapore would have, like, let's take an example of a sandbox approach in case of DSO. Now, sandbox approach in case of DSO would be, let me take five top users of the DSO, which is CSD, Central Security Depositories. In Singapore context, I would take DDCC. We have CCP, Central Clearing Counterparty. I would be taking two. I would be taking Chicago Mercantile Exchange and I would be taking Singapore Stock Exchange. Number three, we have State Street, which is non-banking custody. We have DBS, we have BONI, we have BNY Mellon. And last but not the least, we would be taking the bilaterals. We have multiple bilaterals in place. Example, Goldman Sachs. You know, if you talk about bilaterals without talking about Goldman Sachs and BCN Broker Crossing Network, is completely injustice to their talent. So I repeat, on Central Security Deposit, I would take DTCC. In case of CCP, I would be taking SGX and CME, Chicago Mercantile Exchange. In case of, you know, other user, I would be taking DBS, BONI, you know, State Street, and I would say BNY Mellon. And then I can take the, when it comes to bilateral and broker crossing network, I would be take GS. All these companies would form us from a simplistic setup. And this setup to be produced, this setup to be run in a controlled environment managed by Monetary Authority of Singapore. And then one, and that too in a phase-wise manner. Because digital securities offering is a project which cannot be done on a standalone basis. If it is to be done in a non-phased manner, then it would be a catastrophic scene would happen. 2008 might be a reality soon if this project failed. Now, once this controlled environment it would happen, then Monetary Authority of Singapore will take up a call exactly what was the input and what is the output. Did we fail providing good input? Did we fail providing the appropriate input? Did we came up with a mistake? Or alternatively, everything went well, everything went out well. Input is good, output is good. Then they will get a furnished product. But this furnished product is as per the understanding of the Monetary Authority of Singapore. We need to take another regulators into consideration, the four top regulators like Federal Reserve, European Central Bank, Bank of England, and take Australian National Bank, Central Bank of Australia, although we have many. If you take my view, then at least 7 or 8 top regulators to be considered. Then these regulators will sit together and they deliberate on the input as well as output. Once they deliberate on the input and output, then finally they would get to know exactly what is the final consensus which we'll be having. But again, sandbox approach is having a problem that we can only take a sample up to a limit. I will name you a few securities which would be covered under DSO. Number one, equities. God knows how many type of equities we have in this globe. You know, I need a complete pad, writing pad to describe how many type of equities I'm having. Then you have treasury bill, treasury bond, treasury notes. If I say BMK curve, benchmark curves, there are more than 49 types of benchmark curves we have across the globe, and I need Reuters to justify you, we have more than 49. And every benchmark curve is having a security from 1 month to at least 30 years. So you can very well see that 49 benchmark curve into at least 30 type of securities, more than 1200. Then we are having securities like commercial paper, certificate of deposit, banker acceptance, buyer's credit, and what not. Boss, I need a complete pad to describe what are the different kind of securities we would be having. And even then, I might not be sure that in case I end up missed something. Once the flip side of sandbox approach is that once it would happen, even then Monetary Authority of Singapore might not be completely confident that the tried and tested has been done on a single project. Now that project might be true, might not. That project would work, that sample. So I did some testing on a sample, but I do not know if I'm going to do it on a complete set, whether this would end up correctly or not. I don't know about that. In that sense, what it would happen, I need to wait, and we need to slowly increase the sample size and add more asset classes. So I would add first asset class, second asset class, third asset class, and slowly all asset classes. This is what a sandbox approach is all about. If the DSO would be done like a startup approach, example, Chicago Mercantile Exchange doing of its own, you know, DTCC doing of its own, DBS, Development Bank of Singapore, doing of its own, BONI doing of its own, and everybody is doing of its own, and everybody is coming to their own interpretation, their own conclusion, then it would seriously be a mess. So, to wind up this video, it is pretty much essential, because ICO was a different thing, STO was a different thing, ATO to an extent is a different thing, which is asset tokenization, but DSO, which is digital securities offering, cannot be resolved or cannot be successful provided if you continue to do this via startup approach. I strongly feel that one of the biggest reasons behind the failure of ICO and STO to an extent is the startup approach. And when I'm shooting this video, I would like to let you know that this, sandbox approach basically to be vetted by top four regulators who are pretty good in blockchain. Example, FINRA, Swiss. Example, Hong Kong Monetary Authority. Example, MAS, Monetary Authority of Singapore. Example, Malta, and to an extent, Estonia as well. These four or five regulators has to sit together from a blockchain angle and need to decide that how we would be operating the sandbox. We don't know about that. But yes, one thing which is sure about sandbox is that Treasury Consulting, by December 2019, coming up with a machine learning product. And that machine learning product, we don't know whether this product end up, how this product would be look like, but the asset class of this product would be on the energy derivative. In that regards, we would like to wind up our video. We continue to shoot a lot of videos about blockchain as we now enter into the blockchain. And let me show you that our version of blockchain is better and more functionally competent than we have all versions. We have complete understanding of the banking, which most of the people do not have. And need not to worry about that, need not to tell you that we have an excellent understanding. We have an excellent understanding about the feeders, Reuters and Bloomberg, which hardly people do have. With this, thank you very much and have a great time ahead. You know my mobile number, 9198992429978. And don't forget to visit our fixed income platform, www.fixedincome.global. We thank you very much and have a wonderful time ahead. See you soon.